Okay, viewers, I am backstage right here at Chutney in the Park with no other than K.I. You all know K.I. He is one of the most innovative, exciting, Chutney artist that you will see at the Chutney Soca Monarchs.
You're flattering me. What's up, Lakshmi? How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
A pleasure to be in your show, on your show for the first time. What's up, New York City and all over the world? It's your boy K.I. from GMC Trevini.
Now, guys, you know him, famous for a Catch Me Lover. Now, I gotta ask you, K.I., that's obviously a very controversial song,
of
right?
Course.
Catch Me Lover. What inspired you to sing that song?
That was actually my first song, and I kind of realized when I sang that song, I said, you know what? I want to sing about things that actually happen in the real world. You know, these are things that happen all around us every day. All my songs, actually, No More Rum Again, Womanizer, which is saying every place right now. These are things that occur all over the world. So I said, you know what? Let's start a hit on topics that people can relate to personally and have a bit of fun with it, a bit of humor. And you know, just entertainment, it is what it is.
Now, very exciting. That's something that you stepped out of the box and you did a song like that. But stepping out of the box with your lyrics, you also step out of the box with your entertainment. I mean, things that you do on stage, we never see things like that. I mean, coming out on stage with a humongous piano, people on stage. I mean, tell me a little bit about your creative side. How do you think of these things for your entertainment?
I spent a good portion of my life growing up in Toronto and, you know, just going to concerts, going to Beyonce concerts, Justin Timberlake concerts, to Nelly concerts. You see all these things that they're doing, you know, with our market, it's a lot more smaller.
Okay.
But then you look at the budget we have, and we look at the funding, and we say, listen, we could work so and so. Says, let's be a bit creative, let's come up with some different ideas, not too cliche, and let's try some new things to give the people something brand new to see and enjoy, as opposed to the things they're accustomed to seeing. So we're just always thinking on the grind, yo, we need to do something different, it always changing, so like, we always come up with different things for people to see.
Awesome. Now, you mentioned a couple of different names there, so I'm going to ask you, what is your favorite genre of music?
Music. Not even a genre. I can't say I have a favorite genre of music. My favorite genre of music is just music in general. Because, I mean, everything. You got so many things. You got beautiful chords and a nice music and pop music. You have rhythm and lyrics and hip-hop. There's so many different things. You got energy in soca music. You have soul in R&B. You have so many things. Chutney music on its own is a whole different thing that only we could understand. But listen, I spend most of my time when I'm driving listening to contemporary music, slower things like that, just to take in a bit of different ideas, listen to different lyrics and how they come up with their stuff and try to apply it to my stuff.
Awesome. Now, K.I., what are we going to be expecting from you on stage next?
I got to go on stage and do the best I can, man. It's just No More Rum Again, Techie Girl. Nishad M from my band, I'm going to be doing his song Tequila, How Could She Say, Womanizer, Ketsunita Nadia, and of course a bit of Advantage and everything else. A lot of energy, energetic performance really out here to represent my band JMC Trevini out of Trinidad and Tobago, representing for all the West Indians, trying our hardest to take our culture literally to the next level.
Awesome. Well, can't wait to see you on stage. Thank you.
Thank you so much again, Lakshmi. A pleasure to be on your show. Cheers, everybody. Last night I drink a good few, and I don't know all what I do. I swear I'm tired drinking No More Rum Again. Yo, what's up? It's your boy K.I. from JMC Trevini, and you are watching Let's Talk with Lakshmi. Remember, they calling me womanizer, but I am a Lakshmi lover. Love you.
Okay, viewers, here we are again with none other than the Hitman, and you know when the Hitman hits the stage, there is no like none other. Now, Hitman, I know you've been on Let's Talk with Lakshmi before, and we love having you on. You're getting a lot of hits all over the world. But I know, I gotta ask you, I heard that you've been spending a lot of time in Guyana. What are you doing in Guyana?
Who know, Hitman, Guyana is my home away from home. But we got a lot of shows going on and personal life. I'm in Guyana, so I just loving up Guyana right now. A lot of big things happening in Guyana for Hitman right now.
Yeah. Now, I heard a lot of big things. You just came out with a brand new, hot, heavy, beautiful, gorgeous, steaming new video, music video. Tell our viewers about this new music video.
Well, that video is Soca Chutney, right?
Uh-huh.
But you're late. You know what I'll tell you, you're late? We got something newer than that. And we're going
to
be shooting that video soon. But that video you're talking about, we shoot that video in Guyana. And it's a song like, my heart belongs to you forever and ever. Girl, you know it's true. That's a soca chutney. And it's something that I'm trying to change. You know, in the chutney world, they always say we're doing Hitman known for rum song or whatever. But I'm showing them, yo, it's different. This kind of music we head into right now, soca chutney, is that. And then we come out with something after that. And I know it's something for the broader listening public who looking at chutney music and Hitman bringing something to them that you guys gonna love it. It's really, really, really crazy.
So any collaborations with anybody coming up?
Yeah, it's a collaboration. The latest song I did is with the two-time chutney monarch of Guyana, Fiona, and a guy named Genevieve is a hip-hop artist out of New York and in Guyana based right now. And it's really crazy, and we mix up the chutney with it. So you got chutney with dancehall and hip hop. And the video is gonna start shooting the end of this month.
I gotta tell you, I've been Googling you. I've been YouTubing you. And I saw this really, really hot video with you and an Afro Guyanese girl. I don't know who she is.
Woo.
But oh my God, she is so hot. Who's that girl and how did you start that collaboration?
Well, as I said, right? I do a lot of my music in Guyana right now. I'm recording in Guyana right now. And that girl is one of the hottest soca artists in Guyana, Shelly G. And that song is, I want to wind up on your body all night. I want to make your body feel so right. I want to make your body feel so sweet. You make your thing stand up that afterbeat. Yo, this is what it's about, you know? Chutney music for Hitman is not only chutney music, it's soca chutney. And mixing up with Shelly, that the song I sing there, and then My Heart Belongs to You, and then this latest shoot, where the people are going to be seeing it just now, because we're going to shoot the video just now. It's taking chutney music to a different level, because we need to set that. We need to come out of the box, and this is what Hitman is trying to do. Set chutney music to that level that not only the East Indian public going to watch and love, but the whole wider public. That's what Hitman trying to do, just taking it to a different level.
Now you definitely are. Obviously you have a lot of fans all over Trinidad, Guyana, but now with this Shelly girl, she's Afro-Guyanese, so now I'm sure you must have thousands of Afro-Guyanese fans as well.
That been happening a long time.
Okay.
Because when I did Bring the Rum was with Bungie, you know what I mean? We mix up with the soca, but we did it with the soca, mix the chutney with the soca, and now with Shelly, it's a different level because Shelly's an amazing artist, you know what I mean? Shelly is so versatile, and as an artist, you gotta be versatile. You can't only sing one way. So with that collaboration, it's like, it brings out the best in us. And that way, it's just it, bringing out the best in Hitman, bring out the best in Shelly, and chutney music is like a bullet, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Now Hitman, I gotta say, your videos are very, very impressive. Where does your inspiration come from behind these music videos?
Well, when I started off with video, right, it didn't really have no chutney video. When I did Mr. Shankar, chutney music was, it really didn't have no video. That started the whole revolution of videos, Shankar, and then you got Firewater and everybody just keep coming. So the inspiration is, love the Bollywood songs. I love my Bollywood. You know what I mean? When you see Amitabh Bachchan and you see Rajesh Khanna, I'm a retro kind of guy, you know what I mean? And watching these guys do their thing in this generation right now in Trinidad and the Caribbean and Guyanese public, the inspiration comes from the people and the fans. And looking at that is my inspiration. Giving them that, what they want. And check the music, I gotta say, thanks to the Almighty God, you know what I'm saying? Because God is so great to me. He's been so great to me, I love him. You know what I mean? And I just love the Almighty. He always giving me the idea, he giving me the inspiration, and the people, the fans, that's it. That's what it's about.
Hey man, we're seeing our chutney artists, our soca artists hitting it big. I mean, a couple months ago, some of our artists hit Madison Square Garden in New York City. Now that is big. So I know when you say that you see chutney soca go to another level, you're thinking really, really big. Where should we see Hitman in the next 5 years?
Well, see chutney music in Madison Garden is great. I love it. If not only one artist can do it, Hitman alone can't do it. And when I see my other brothers in the business doing something like that, I'd be so proud, you know what I mean? And when somebody make that breakthrough, it helped me to go through too. And chutney music, there's no limit. And once the Almighty give me that blessing, I'm just going to be pushing it. And one day, my goal is to make the world know, check the music, and love it the way how I love it. You know what I mean? Chinese, white, black, Syrian, you name it. The world, they gotta love it, because I love it.
They gotta love it. Thank you, honey, so much.
No problem. Bye. Hey dear sexy lady, if no buts, no maybe, tonight I want to make you mine. Yo, this is your boy Hitman, and you're locked on to Lakshmi, the most sexiest woman right now in the entertainment. She pushing it to the level. Big up!
What? Talk about this! Talk about that!
You ready?
Let's go!
Okay guys, I'm here with none other than the hot Adrian Dutton. You know him better for TikTok, okay? And his famous collaboration with Terry Gazrod and Rob Drinkins. So Adrian, tell me, first of all, how does it feel to be one of the number one Guyanese soca artists?
Let me tell you, right now, first of all, let me give thanks that you guys interview me. Thank you for the interview. It feels great. I'm a grown-up person. This is my first chutney in the park.
Okay.
I'm having a beautiful time. The people are loving people. Guyanese, Trinidadian, everybody just real cool. I'm loving it.
Now, I heard you're absolutely famous. I heard that you have the best fine wine that you can possibly see. So, I'd tell you to tell us about the little fine wine, but I think I'd rather see it. What do you think?
You know, listen, I don't think it's a fine wine. It's just a wine, but I add a little honey to it. And women seem to like it.
Uh-huh.
So, right here or right now, I'm going to teach you to do a little thing. Come on, I'm going to teach you. Open like this.
Okay.
You know, let me say this. Terry Gadraj is one of the most down-to-earth people you'll ever reach. I love Terry. Terry is my friend for life. We did a show in DC last week. We mashed it up. Terry, the remix was actually with myself, Terry, and the Hitman. We're all friends. And this thing is nothing about race. It's about love. We mash up the stage, and we're gonna do the same thing in Canada for Caravana. Myself and Terry have more music to come, and we have a lot of things to do. So, people, trust me, we're gonna unite the Caribbean. We're gonna unite the world even more.
So, what can we expect from you on stage?
Well, actually, I already mashed the stage up. I was whining so hard, I sweat. It was crazy. The people just loved myself. I was with SW Storm and the Raw. I had a ball.
I gotta ask you, did you take off your shirt?
Of course. It was off. Yeah. I had people wind to the side. What? Look at what? Wind to the what? This is crazy, people. Chutney in the park right now. I'm having a ball. Adrian Dutton with this beautiful young lady. Look, we gotta smile for the picture. We're loving it. Thank you so much for this interview. Thank you so much. I went to a soca party. I will busy fit in GT. Yo, this is Adrian Dutton and you're watching Let's Talk with the sexy lady, Lakshmi, right here, right now. You know how we do it. Let's go!
I'm Diane Bisuomagat, branch manager of your local neighborhood Citibank branch here on Liberty Avenue in Richmond Hill. And even in today's current economic environment, Citi remains a reputable and trustworthy institution that continues to be committed to the communities in which we live and work. And with mortgage rates at a historical 10-year low, when was the last time you sat down with a financial expert to review your mortgage situation? Is your mortgage over 10 years old? Do you have an adjustable rate? Or are you thinking of purchasing your first home? We're offering special rates and closing cost discounts. Stop into the branch on 121 Street and Liberty Avenue or call the number at the bottom of the screen. Be sure to mention this TV ad for additional rates and closing cost discounts. This is a limited time offer, so act fast.
Okay, viewers, I'm here with none other than the sexy, the hot, the extreme SW Storm himself from The Raw Band. Now, SW Storm, I know you've been in the music industry for quite a while, since 1997, but I know you, when you came out with your hit song, Pong Pong, that's when you blew up the charts. So tell me a little bit about that song, Pong Pong, and why you think that became so famous.
Well, like you said, I've been around since 1997 was my first hit in Trinidad, a soca track called Nice. And I've been consistently producing soca music, the odd chutney soca.
Okay.
But certain people knew me. I was based in England for a long time. They say I have an accent, but I don't think I have an accent.
We're the ones with the accent.
Okay. Yeah. So last year, I linked up with Big Rich in Trinidad,
okay.
And I recorded a song called The Hammer, also known as Pong Pong, and that just blew up for me. And from that, that just put me out to the world. And since that, everybody, it's just so much love I've had from the people, so much from the fans. And then I came again this year with Bidey Bar.
Another real big hit.
And then I had Come My Darling a little earlier. Two, three weeks ago, I released another tune destined to be another monster called Pop the Chunk. Pop the Chunk, come now tell me what are you taking? Pop the Chunk, we loaded up and we limeing.
So I gotta ask you, what ethnicity are you?
My parents are Trinidadian.
Okay.
I was born and raised in London, England. My father's Trinidadian Indian, and my mother's Trinidadian Portuguese, Spanish, and French. So we call that a real Kalalu.
That's a real cook-up. We'll call that a Guyana. A real cook-up. I know this is your second chutney in the pot, but this is the first time you're going to be performing with your band?
Well, yeah, this is the first time I've performed with my band. Last year I performed here, and I worked with my backing tracks.
Okay.
But after Trinidad Carnival this year, I went back to Toronto in March, and I said, I'm forming my own band, and I'm going to call it The Roar. Right? I like the name, The Edgy, and it had to be edgy and a powerhouse band. And I'll tell you what, we launched in April, and from April to April, May, June, July, it's unbelievable where we have reached up to now. And I swear to you, by next year, more music, lots of more recordings, music, shows, we're gonna be out there. And like the fans, we love the fans. The fans have given us a lot of love. And New York, what a wonderful town.
Now, Storm, the show's not only in New York, but it's in Guyana too. So any words for the Guyanese fans?
Oh my God, Guyana. I was in Guyana March for Clash of the Titans, my first experience in Guyana. I swear, I love Guyana. I had such a wonderful time and the people are amazing. I actually think my background is Trinidadian, but I actually think I have more Guyanese fans and following than Trinidadian. But you know, when I say Trinidadian, Guyanese, it's one love, we're the same people.
One love, one nation. Now, my last thing to you. I'm here talking to you, and oh my God, I'm falling in love with your non-accent, right? Your non-accent.
I don't have an accent.
Okay. But when you sing, you don't sing with this English tone.
It's very strange, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's kind of rather odd.
Very odd. How do you pull that off?
I grew up, my parents are Trinidadian,
yeah.
And as a child, I grew up as a West Indian child. Even though I grew up in England, I didn't grow up eating fish and chips and steak and kidney pie and chip. I grew up eating stew chicken and kalalu, curry chicken, curry duck and roti and chicken.
Right.
So I grew up from food to the way my parents brought me up. Even to the ladies, I love them. Right? I've always been a West Indian at heart. So yes, you say I have an accent. I don't think I have an accent. I sound a little different, I guess.
But I'm a West Indian to the heart and to the bone, and I love my culture and I love my music. And like I said, I've taken soca music and chutney soca all over Europe, all over the world. I've been to Sri Lanka, Dubai.
I've been
all over the world promoting and carrying this music, even before people knew me with Bong Bong. And now Bong Bong, By the Bar, Poppy Trunk, SW Storm and the Roar. You know, I mean, it's beautiful.
All right, viewers, so you heard it right here first on Let's Talk with Lakshmi, SW Storm and the Raw. He's just about to go hit it, kill it up on stage, Chutney in the Bar.
This is SW Storm and you're watching Let's Talk with Lakshmi. Me and my friends, climbing by the bar, having a good time and beating liquor. Bring the rum, bring the rum, bring the rum come. Me and Lakshmi, we climbing by the bar. Love ya, SW Storm.
Okay, viewers, I'm here with none other than Hunter himself. You all know him. He's famous for jumping Shanana and Robin the Morning. My first question is, how does it feel to come out and perform for Chutney in the Park?
Well, I've been here from start, and I believe this is one of the most popular year because it looks real good on the outside. If you're not here right now, personally, you're missing a real treat. You understand? And I believe 2011, if you're not here, make sure 2012 you're here for real on the inside, because I feel personally that this fest is growing and growing and growing, because this year is like what, the fourth year, and it looks tremendous on the outside.
Now, viewers, we all know that Hudson was one of the finalists in the Chutney Soca Monarch, and one of his famous songs is Rum in the Morning. Now, you bought that song, Rum in the Morning, all around the world. Everyone loves that song wherever they are in the Caribbean, whether it be Guyana, Trinidad, Suriname, Jamaica. Tell me a little bit, what inspired you to sing that song?
Well, actually, you know, I tried to like change the music from a different angle to where it was, and put it like in a more slower pace and where everybody could relate to it, you know, and I believe I did a good job by doing it. And what inspired me to write that song is like, I was sitting in the studio one day, me and Big Rich and a guy named Sergio Amujab, and I just sat down there and I just, you know, that song came from a popular song from the movie called Dosti. The song is go like, Kia Hunga Me Tuje. It go like, Kia Hunga Me Tuje. So, yeah, so while sitting in the studio, I was taking a drink and I said, I just pull out, Kia Hunga Me Tuje. And Big Rich say, yo, that song, take it and write a rum song. And in about 20 minutes time, I call him back. I said, Big Rich, hear this. You could bring it in a bottle, you could bring it in a flask, you could bring it in a cup, you could send it in a glass. I want the rum in the morning, I want the rum in the evening. Don't know.
Wait, now tell me a little bit about Jumpsing Shanana. First of all, I gotta tell you, the video and that, the music video is hilarious. Hilarious.
All right.
What made you think about that?
What, the video or the song?
Song first. Right. I mean, I know that does come from a Bollywood, comes from a Bollywood movie.
Yeah.
But tell me a little bit about what inspired you to do that, and then the video. I'm telling you, I crack up at that video.
Well, actually, it was a popular song by Sean, Jepsy Sidinena. And I just, you know, being the crazy individual I am, I always think beyond the bracket. I always think different. I don't know. I can't explain it to you, but I have a different imagination. And I just drive down the road in my car one day and I say, Jepsy Terinaina on the radio. And I say, Jepsy Naina, and she be Haina, now she can Haina. That is exactly how I came up with that song.
So let me ask you, did a bee ever sting your butt?
Huh?
Did a bee ever sting your butt?
If what?
Did you ever get stung by a bee?
I get stung plenty of time, but not behind her. Like my neck and my head and my hand and stuff, but nothing behind her. No.
So Hunter, tell me, what can we expect from you next?
Well, you know, Hunter Man, working on some new songs. I have a song with I don't know if you guys know Santana from the internet. You know Santana? Well, I and Santana have a song coming out next year. Yeah, that's gonna be magical, trust me, for real. Me and Santana. Santana, bitch, yeah, for real.
A winner for Chutney Soca Monarch?
Actually, that is more like on the soca level.
Okay.
Yeah, so my Chutney songs, I haven't sit down and we actually write them off yet, but I have different songs coming out except that.
And any collaborations?
Well, Santana is one, and while the thing go along, maybe I'll see who could jump in and stuff.
Awesome, well, thank
Thank you. All righty then. Yo, this is the Hunter Man. Right now, you're viewing. Let's talk with Lakshmi. Hunter Man says so. Don't touch that, you know what? Hunter Man says so. Boom, blazing fire. Boom.
Okay, viewers, we are backstage with none other than Anil Bhim. Now, you all know who Anil Bhim is. He has one of the top Bollywood voices in Trinidad and Tobago. And it is indeed, Mr. Bhim, an honor to be standing here with you right now to get this two-minute interview with you on Let's Talk with Lakshmi.
My pleasure. How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
No problem.
So, my first question is, what inspired you to start singing?
Actually, my singing career started off, I would say by
childhood.
Very naturally. I come from a big musical family.
Okay.
And I guess it was just a matter of time before I branched off into the whole thing. So everything was just a very natural flow into the whole thing. I started a little bit late. I started singing when I was 19. Mom, as many people would know, Primitive Beam was a mega star back in those days. And I guess it was just a matter of time before I came into the whole thing.
Yeah, so they say the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. So now I know that you're famous for the Bollywood songs, also bhajans.
Yeah.
So tell our audience, what is your favorite song?
Well, favorite song, I don't have a favorite song, but as you mentioned earlier on, I'm known for Bollywood songs and for bhajans. And but what people don't know about me is I'm a total entertainment package when it comes to jumping on that stage. Anil Bhim gives you every single thing that is happening. See, today I'm in Chutney in the Park. Where in the world will you find a bhajan and a film singer in an event like Chutney in the Park?
Right.
At the same time, you would find me in concert for a whole sit-down crowd. So I like to think of myself as a very versatile artist who would always like to deliver to whatever type of atmosphere. So I've been blessed so far to always be involved in some of the more happening events, whether it's a party or a nice sit-down concert, or even a religious function, or even a private function, you know what I mean? So it's just a matter of keep things going, but I enjoy partying. I enjoy seeing people tears fill up in their eyes. So to say I have a favorite selection, not really.
Okay. So being as versatile as you are, do you have a favorite genre of music?
Indian music. I'm proud of my Indian music. I'm absolutely proud of whatever Indianness means to people. I would like to think of myself of executing that to people.
So what can we be expecting next from you?
Next, originals. And I know many people have been talking about originals. Not the Bollywood thing with the English melodies and things, and vice versa, but total original. I mean, I've started to do some serious productions recently. Linked up with some really good writers as well. And you can look forward to a very new song coming out from Anil Bhim and my productions.
Any collaborations with any other artists that we may
know of? Lots of artists. It's long overdue. Look out for collaborations with all the big Indian artists, some on the western side as well. Lots of good things are going to happen very soon.
Awesome. Now, I know, what can we expect to see from you on stage today?
Tonight, Anil Bhim in a totally different mood. Fire, fet, party, bacchanal, and some love in the middle.
Awesome. Can't wait to see you on stage.
Yeah, it's going to be good. Thanks, Lakshmi, and big up to your TV crew. I mean, you guys continue to do what you need to do. Whoever, in whatever form, does anything to promote culture on the whole, I mean, that has to be commended. So keep up the good work, guys. Big up. And love you, Guyana. Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy, Anil Bhim. Right now, you're on to Let's Talk with your girl, Lakshmi. This definitely is the show. Check it out. Stay locked.
I'm Diane Bisuomagat, branch manager of your local neighborhood Citibank branch here on Liberty Avenue in Richmond Hill. And even in today's current economic environment, Citi remains a reputable and trustworthy institution that continues to be committed to the communities in which we live and work. And with mortgage rates at a historical 10-year low, when was the last time you sat down with a financial expert to review your mortgage situation? Is your mortgage over 10 years old? Do you have an adjustable rate? Or are you thinking of purchasing your first home? We're offering special rates and closing cost discounts. Stop into the branch on 121 Street and Liberty Avenue, or call the number at the bottom of the screen. Be sure to mention this TV ad for additional rates and closing cost discounts. This is a limited time offer, so act fast.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's the King Raj from the Supertones Band, and you're watching Let's Talk with Lakshmi.
What's up? This is your girl Sassy, and you're locked on right here, nowhere else. Keep it locked.
Hello viewers again from Let's Talk with Lakshmi. We are here backstage at Chutney in the Park, New York City. And we are here with none other than Gregory, the man from Karma right now. We did Ravi B before, Nisha B interview as well. But now we're here with another lead frontline man on the front line with his performances and singing. We're here with Gregory himself. The ladies want to hear from you finally on Let's Talk with Lakshmi. So how does it feel to be in New York again, Gregory?
It feels fantastic, man. Same feeling like all the other carnivals. It's just New York has a nice vibe to it. It have same vibe but have a little more gist, you know, a little more energy. You smell that, yeah, we coming, you know. And as you know, we did our thing on stage. It was a good performance. Everyone, you know, the response was fantastic, phenomenal, you know. And we keep on doing it every year, Chutney Park.
Well, I see you guys a lot, and every time, I must say, Karma brings it every performance, and I see you guys, it's better and better and better every time. What else can we expect from your band?
You can expect, you know, we always aim for the sky, you know, nothing is the limit for us right now. We're just trying to see what, you know, in terms of choreography, from down to the songs, down to the sets. And, you know, Karma before was known as a chutney band alone, but the market we're hitting right now is more cooperative gigs and stuff, you know, like any hired, you know, gigs for like BP, British Gas and those companies. So, you know, a lot of songs that we change up in the repertoire, like Lionel Richie and the Commodores, you know, a lot of old school, we're mixing it up, we're bringing back that whole feel again, you know, so you're getting chutney, you're getting soca, you're getting reggaeton, you're getting dub, you're getting all genres of music, so.
Well, Lakshmi said to make sure I get from you at least a wine or something like that, because you do it on stage and all the ladies want to see it. So let's talk with Lakshmi. Here's Gregory with a little something something. He's whining on stage, right?
I could do a little singing, a little personal a cappella for y'all, you know, and to show.
That sounds good.
You know? I'll go, oh, tune for the gal them, tune for the gal them, tune for the gal them. My girl just, oh, make your bumper drop, roll out of control. Can wind up your body, gal, shake it some more, gal. Hey.
Nice. Once again, Gregory from the big band Karma. Thank you.
Hey, it's your boy Gregory from the band Karma, and you're live with Let's Talk with Lakshmi. Make your bumper drop, roll out of control, gal. Wind up your body, gal. Push it some more. Hey, keep it locked, always. You're here with Lakshmi.
All right, Let's Talk with Lakshmi viewers. I am here with, but before I introduce you to her, first I need you to say good morning to everyone.
Good morning, everyone.
You know that voice, right? That's the Bacchanal Radio DJ herself, DJ Rose, chilling with Rose every morning on BacchanalRadio.com. How are you, Rose?
Well, I am feeling fabulous. It is an end to something that was spectacular for me. Feeling really great.
Very nice. So you're here at Chutney in the Park with all these amazing artists on stage, crowds and tons of people here. We're here backstage. What's the feeling going on right now? What's really happening at Chutney in the Park? What's your take on it?
Well, my take on it, it's my first year being here and I have truly been missing out. It is nothing like being at a concert in the club. You're free here, so much people, and when they say Trini, the flags go up. You see a sea of people. When they say Guyana, the flags go up. It is just spectacular. So many artists came in just for this show. Really, truly enjoyable.
I'm hearing your voice, but I feel like I'm listening to the radio right now. So right now, give us a plug on Let's Talk with Lakshmi. Where can we hear your voice again?
Absolutely. Listeners, I'd like to invite you, if you don't listen to me on BacchanalRadio.com, every weekday from Monday through Friday from 7 to 9:30, sometimes 10. Trust me, I know how mornings can be rushing, hitting the alarm, the snooze button, want to go back to sleep, but I will definitely inform you and help you to start your day the right way.
Thank you, Rose. All right, viewers, on Let's Talk with Lakshmi, I'm here now with the manager of G6 Revolution, Rita, a.k.a. Hair Guru herself, to tell us what she thinks about Chutney in the Park right now in New York.
Chutney in the Park, you can't go wrong. It's like the all-stars of the biggest and the baddest. They're all in one venue. Real worth it, definitely, for sure.
Nice. How do you feel about the bands on stage and all the artists and the people in the audience?
It gets better every year for sure.
Well, you know, Rita, Lakshmi says you're the hottest female manager of a band, the hottest in New York right now. So we want to know, give us a plug for your band, tell us.
G6 Revolution, come and experience. It's an experience worth coming to look at.
Viewers, we come in. All right, viewers of Let's Talk with Lakshmi, I'm here with the big man himself on the radio. You'll recognize his voice, Big Daddy from Bacchanal Radio, out from Trinidad for Chutney in the Park. How's it going? Welcome to New York again.
Well, I feel like I need to get a house in New York. Nobody should be telling me welcome to New York. It's like every week. So, like, you know, just it's like don't even say that again.
All right, all right.
You're in New York. You're living in New York. That is it. Isaac, a New York resident, right now.
So, how the vibe right now for Chutney in the Park?
Chutney in the Park, the vibe was real, real, real great. I mean, you know, we didn't have any rain. We didn't have anything in terms of the weather affecting us. We had a real nice program. Everything ran smoothly. We really would have wanted to go a little longer, I know. But, you know, that's how things go sometimes. But everything was really great. Performance was, you know, all the performances were real great. Dances, the singers, the, you know, every entertainer that was on the cast, really, really great. Top of the line.
So basically, it was just like in Trinidad out here with the weather and everything, right?
Yeah, actually, when I reached, I was like, oh God, thank the Lord. I don't have to bring no jacket. I don't have to bring no kind of coat, nothing like that. I'm loving the weather. Summertime, best time to come here for me.
Very nice. So tell our listeners and viewers right now, when can we hear Big Daddy on the radio?
Well, I'm supposed to be on the radio tonight, but I really doubt I'll be on the radio tonight. Probably tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock, okay. Which is Monday morning.
And when are you normally on?
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Saturday morning. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Saturday morning at 9:30 to 10, and Sunday night, our love program at 9 o'clock.
Very nice. BacchanalRadio.com. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.
Every time I see this guy, I just gotta stop him because you know who he is. He is the heartbreaker. So, Ranjeev, this is the first time you're at Chutney in the Park performing as a solo artist.
Yes.
So, a lot of people would say that young boy, he made it. How do you feel about it?
I feel amazing. I feel really, really amazing. I mean, for me to share the stage with big Chutney artists like this, it's a feeling that I can't express, you know. Next year, I know, hopefully, you know, my new band, the G6 Revolution, will definitely be on here next year. I already spoke to the management, and we're working towards that, but it's amazing to just be in this environment with big artists like, the, you know, Ravi B, Soca Elvis, SW Storm. It's amazing. It's an accomplishment for me. K.I., don't forget K.I., my biggest Chutney Soca artist in my world, you know what I mean? But definitely, I mean, it's amazing. It's amazing.
So, Reggie, when you step on stage for all of these, let's say, godfathers of Chutney Soca, and you're the baby coming in, how do you feel?
I feel like, well, you know, honestly, all these guys support me. They support me. They support my music. Ravi came up and told me he loves my new song, Leaving For Sure. So he said it's doing well in Trinidad. Unfortunately, I'm not there to promote it as well, but it's doing well. But it's just a pleasure, it's an honor, I think, just to be on stage with these guys, you know?
Now, for the past couple of months, I've been seeing your name everywhere. Florida, New York City, here at Chutney in the Park, Canada. I think I saw something for you, too.
The whole Caribana weekend, I'm there Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, I'm performing, so.
Now, I know Eastern Parkway, Brooklyn.
Yeah, well, we're working on some stuff for Eastern Parkway. We're not too sure yet, but that's still in the works, you know? So.
Now, you just came off stage and you teared it up. All the girls were screaming for the heartbreaker.
Well, what are you going to do? I'm the heartbreaker, right? They want to know what's this heartbreaking thing about. So everybody was curious about it, but, you know.
All right, so Reggie, give our audiences a piece of your brand new song, Leaving For Sure.
Definitely. So this is my brand new song, Leaving For Sure. I want to tell you. How could you do this to me? Torture was my baby. Now I know why we can't marry. So don't blame your mommy. You never really love me. You just want me, man. You always tell me, yeah. You always tell me that you love me forever. And now I realize you played me up. Yo, this is Ranjeev, the heartbreaker, right? And you're tuning in to Let's Talk with Lakshmi. Hey!
Okay, viewers, we just came off the stage with none other than Ravi B. He is absolutely no stranger to Let's Talk with Lakshmi. I know all you guys are seeing him in Guyana, in New York City, in Trinidad, all over the world. Now, Ravi, you just came off the stage. You just killed it right here in Chutney in the Park. Tell me, how did you feel about that?
I mean, I felt good, you know. I felt good. I can't describe it better. My first performance of the year here in New York City. And seeing about 8,000 people in this park today, you know, it justifies and shows that, you know, karma we are at a different level right now. And the idea about Madison Square is growing for next year. So we're looking at Mother's Day weekend next year, by the way.
All right. Now, Ravi, I know I'm seeing your pictures all over the place. You just performed out in Guyana. Now, the show now is in, Let's Talk with Lakshmi is now in Guyana. Mm-hmm. So I want you to tell the viewers in Guyana a little something, a little special message for them out there, because I know they were going crazy. I see your Facebook, all of the people in Guyana just going crazy for you. I hear when you go out there, they'd be like ripping you up, wanting to rip off your clothes.
I just love Guyana, you know what I mean? Karma cannot perform in Guyana without over 20,000 people in the stadium, you know what I mean? It'd be real cool, I respect. And I think Guyana is my second home. Believe it or not, everybody in Guyana who watching this, I am buying a piece of land in Guyana. Yeah, believe it or not, right by Buddy somewhere there.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I'm organizing to buy a piece of land there because I think it's like a second home to me. And I really love the warm feeling of the Guyanese people towards my love for music, man.
Awesome, awesome. And Ravi, I'm seeing your clothesline coming out. Tell our viewers a little bit about your clothesline and where can we get it?
Well, the clothesline is out. You can get the t-shirts, you can get the ladies' tops, you can get the baby t-shirts as well. And next 2 weeks, we're coming out with the ladies' short pants and we're marking Budo on the butt, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
So that's gonna go crazy. You can buy it online at nillylicious.com. My sister in Miami, she's in charge of that. To my friends in Guyana, we'll be launching the line in Guyana in August, hopefully in August, because...
So you're going to be there in August?
Yeah, I'm going back for Jam Zone.
Okay.
I understand that, I don't want to say who coming, but somebody huge is coming for Jam Zone. Mm-hmm. And Karma is definitely going to be there. And hopefully I will get to launch my clothing line in Guyana that weekend as well.
Okay, and now in the music line, what's the next hottest thing we can expect from Ravi B and Karma?
Ravi B, as an artist right now, I already finished 10 songs that I wanted to release for summer, but you know, I think the road's doing well, the kyakum and the play and the way this, the drinker and everything, it's still happening for me, right? So I decided that I'll take my time and release it and step as we get closer for Carnival, because we have a really huge event coming up for Carnival. I really want to put all my concentration on for next year. So where music is concerned, Karma, we are definitely going forward.
Okay.
We have a new CD coming out, Mr. Chutney Soka. Nisha B is coming out with a CD as well. And I am doing a separate album with only like Kishore Kumar and Rafi, because I want to give back to the people now. For my Father's Day show, I didn't realize that people didn't know I do these kind of songs.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm doing a whole album with just like Rafi, Kishore Kumar, and Nisha will be doing some Lata Mangeshkar and stuff like that. We want to call it the River CD. You know what I mean? When you go to the river now, you're not only hearing chutney, but you're hearing the old Bollywood stuff and things.
The oldies.
So, yeah, mm-hmm. So that's what really happened with Karma. Nisha B is also doing something international. Things might happen when Nisha is doing a production to be in a movie. So you can look out for that. Hopefully, awesome. Let's keep our fingers crossed. Let's see if the Caribbean can take it to a higher level again.
Of course, of course. Thank you.
Yeah, man, respect. Budo. Buy she a rose, take she dinner, take she to drink a mocachella. Budo, this is Ravi B. And you're watching Let's Talk with Lakshmi. Aya!
Again, now. Whoa.